lecture we are going to study about Jawar's shoot fly. This is one of the important pests of Jawar. Jawar shoot fly is classified as phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Diptera, family Anthomidae, and genus and species names are Antherigona varia socata. This is the generic and specific name. And the other host plants on which it is found or it infests, the other host plants are wheat, maize and bajra. Then moving to the nature of damage, the maggots or larvae bore into the stem of jawar up to 4 weeks from the germination and cause dead hearts. So these dipteran larvae, they are called the maggots. Maximum infestation is observed in the 3rd and 4th week after sowing of the seed. It is one of the important or most important pest of sorghum, that is jawar, and in case of severe attack necessitating re-sowing of crops, the tillers coming out from the infested plants are also attacked in extent. Also attacked in turn by the pest. The late sown sorghum or jawar is damaged to a greater extent than early sown crop. The incidence is generally severe on sorghum sown between second fortnight of October and first fortnight of February. So this is the life cycle in which you can see the adult fly, the maggot inside the shoot, and full grown maggot. Moving to the identification and life history. So adult fly is, it looks like the house fly, but it is smaller in size, only about 3 millimeters in length. They love sunlight and leave for a month. They feed on honeydew and other sweet material available in nature. This adult fly is exactly like a house fly, but the size varies, that is, it is smaller in size, about 3 millimeters, and it feeds on sweet food material. Then it lay eggs. The eggs, the fly lays whitish cigar shaped, means cylindrical shaped eggs singly on a ventral surface of the 3rd and 4th leaves. A single fly lays about 40 eggs and the incubation period goes for 1 to 4 days. Then it hatches into a larva, which is commonly called as maggots in dipteran insects. So remember this word, this thing, that the maggots are nothing but the larva of dipteran insects. The maggots migrate to the dorsal surface of leaves. Then these maggots, because the eggs hatches, eggs are laid on the ventral surface, and after complete incubation period they hatch into a maggot or larva, and then further they migrate to the dorsal surface of the leaves under the space between the leaf sheath and axis and make a clean cut at the base of the leaf. The central succulent core begins to decay and the maggots feed on rotten material. The larval period lasts for 6 to 12 days. Then the next stage is pupa. Pupation takes place in the soil or plant stem. The fly emerges after a week. 1 week is required for this complete development of the fly inside the pupal case. And means the pupal period lasts for 6 to 8 days. Then the control measures of the pests are, as the insect affects very young plants, use of higher seed rate and removal of affected and extra plants at thinning 4 weeks after sowing should be adopted to cut down the cost of cultivation. Second is seed furrow application of thymet. Some important pesticides like thymet, disulfiton 5 grams and thymet 10 grams at the rate of 1 to 1.5 kilogram actual ingredient per hectare affords appreciable protection. So these chemicals we can prefer here for the control of this pest, and as well as you can use the seed treatment technique with carbofuran. Means if we treat the seeds before sowing with the carbofuran, it could also be very effective control measures to control the jawar shoot fly. And this is also called as sorghum shoot fly. So this is all about the classification, then identification, life history, and the control measures, nature of damage as well. We have seen all these points in short. So I hope you understand this point. If you like this video, please share, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.